Hello everyone. Hope you are doing well. I am Akshay Parmar, Assistant Professor at LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology in ITIC Department. Welcome to the video tutorial series of the data communication and the computer networks. Today we will discuss another error and flow control strategy, selective repeat or reject ARQ protocol, and after that we will see the HDLC protocol. Right. So let's outline of the today's session. First of all, in this video, we will discuss selective repeat ARQ protocol in brief, and after that we will see the HDLC protocol in brief. So let's begin with the selective repeat or reject protocol. In our previous video, we have seen so many techniques. In our previous method, if any particular frame is damaged, not received successfully, all the frames after that are retransmitted. But in this selective repeat or reject protocol, the specific damaged or unreceived frame is retransmitted. In this, if a frame is corrupted in the transmission, the negative acknowledgement is returned to confirm that frame is corrupted or it is received erroneous, right? And the frame is resent out of the sequence, right? Likewise, if any frame in between is having an erroneous bit or it is corrupted during the transmission, only that frame's negative acknowledgement is sent, and by that negative acknowledgement the sender is confirming that this is the damaged frame, so it is retransmitted that frame only, not other frames, right? The receiving device must be able to short to three frames and insert the retransmitted frame into its proper place in sequence, right? The receiving device must be able to short to three frames and insert the retransmitted frame into the proper place in sequence. As we are requesting only the damaged or erroneous frame, so the receiver must be able to rearrange that received frame, right? So if any frame is erroneous, so the sender will retransmit that frame, right? So after getting that actual frame, what to do with that? So the receiver device will rearrange that frame in its proper sequence, right? So that's how the selective repeat or reject protocol is working. Damaged frame. Let's take an example. In that, the data frame 2 is arrived and it is found that it is having an error, right? It is erroneous. It is corrupted during the transmission. So the negative acknowledgement 2 is returned from the receiver end, right? Which is telling the sender that your data frame 2 is corrupted during the transmission, right? The negative acknowledgement 2 tells the sender that data 0 and data 1 have been accepted successfully, but data 2 must be resent, right? The receiver accepts the data 3, 4, 5. While waiting for a new copy of the data frame 2, right? So when the new data frame 2 arrives, the acknowledgement 6 can be returned and acknowledge the new data frame 2, and the original data frame 3, 4 and 5 are rearranged, right? After getting that new data frame 2, it is rearranged in between after the data frame 1 and before the data frame 3, right? So the data frame 3, 4 and 5 are accepted during the waiting of the data frame 2, right? Let's see by the diagrammatical example, right? As we have discussed, the sender is sending the so many frames simultaneously, right? One by one. The sender is sending frames one by one while waiting for the acknowledgement, right? So in this example, the data frame 0, data frame 1 and data frame 2 is sended from the sender side at the receiver end. The receiver is accepting the data frame 0, data frame 1 and data frame 2, right? So data frame 0 and data frame 1 is uncorrupted and it is not erroneous, so right, so it is accepted successfully. After that, the receiver is observing the data frame 2 is an error, right? Some error is there. So the receiver is finding some error in the data frame 2. So the receiver will send the negative acknowledgement 2 to the sender side to confirm that the data frame 0 and data frame 1 are received successfully and there are no errors. But the data frame 2 is having some error. So the data frame, the receiver will send the negative acknowledgement to at the sender side. Meanwhile, the sender is sending the data frame 3 and data frame 4 and so on, right? So data frame 3 and data frame 4 is send it while waiting for the acknowledgement from the receiver end. Either it is a acknowledgement or the negative acknowledgement, right? After getting the negative acknowledgement 2, from the receiver end, sender is knowing that data frame 0 and data frame 1 is received successfully and there are no error, and the there is the error in the data frame 2, right? So receiver is seeking for the data frame 2. So the sender is sending the data frame 2 again, right? So likewise, if the any frame is erroneous and corrupted during the transmission, it is retransmitted that particular frame only, not other frames are retransmitted in this selective repeat and reject protocol, right? So what if the data frame is lost during the transmission? So let's observe a lost frame scenario. If the frame is lost, the next frame will be arrived out of the sequence, right? If the frame is lost, the next frame will be the arrived out of sequence. The receiver will send negative acknowledgement 2 at the sender side after receiving the frame 3, right? That is the out of sequence. In our example, we have taken that the sender is sending the data frame 0, after the data frame 1, after the data frame 2, after that data frame 3. But meanwhile, during the transmission, data frame 2 is not received at the receiver end. It is lost during the transmission and data frame 2 is not received at the receiver end. After that, the data frame 3 is received at the receiver end. So it is out of the sequence. So the receiver will send the negative acknowledgement to the sender side, right? That negative acknowledgement 2 is telling the sender that the frame 0 and the frame 1 are received successfully and the data frame 2 is lost or corrupted. The receiver accepts the data frame 3, 4, 5 while waiting for the new copy of the data frame 2, right? After receiving the negative acknowledgement 2 from the receiver end, the sender will retransmit the data frame 2 and that frame is rearranged in the sequence by the receiver end. Let's see an example, right? So in that, sender is sending the data frame 0, data frame 1 and so on, right? But meanwhile, during the transmission, data frame 1 is lost during the transmission and it is not received at the receiver end, right? After that, whenever the data frame 2 is sent in by the sender side and received at the receiver end, the receiver has come to know that it is out of sequence, right? Then we have received data frame 0. After that, we need to receive a data frame 1 and we are receiving the data frame 2. So there are the missing other data frame 1. So it has come to know that the data frame 1 is lost during the transmission. So after knowing that the receiver is sending the negative acknowledgement 1 to the sender side. Meanwhile, the sender is sending the data frame 3 and data frame 4, and which is accepted at the receiver end. And meanwhile, the receiver is waiting for the data frame 1, which is lost during the transmission, right? After getting the negative acknowledgement 1 from the receiver end, the sender has come to know that there is something happened with the data frame 1. Either it is lost during the transmission or it is erroneous or corrupted during the transmission, right? So the receiver has not received the original copy of the data frame 1. So sender is retransmitting the data frame 1 to the receiver end. So that's how the selective repeat or reject protocol is handling if the frame is lost during the transmission. There are another scenario in which the selective repeat or reject protocol is handling this, right? So in that, the acknowledgement is lost, right? So let's see an scenario. The sender waits a predetermined amount of the time, then retransmit, then unacknowledged frame, right? The receiver recognizes that the new transmission is repeat of the earlier one and send another acknowledgement and discard the duplicate data. Let's see by example, right? So sender is sending the data frame, right? After receiving that data frame, receiver is acknowledging that we have received that data frame 0 and we are seeking for the data frame 1, right? So meanwhile, the sender is sending the data frames, right? Data frame 1 is sent. After that, it is sending the acknowledgement that the data frame 0 and data frame 1 is received successfully, and now we are waiting for the data frame 2, right? So the receiver is sending the acknowledgement 2, which is saying that we have received data frame 1 and data frame 2 successfully, and now we are seeking for the data frame 2. But somehow the data acknowledgement 2 is lost during the transmission. Meanwhile, the sender is sending the data frame 2 and so on, right? So after the sending the data frame 2, it is sending the acknowledgement 3, right? Meanwhile, the data frame 314 is sending, right? The resender is continuous sending the data at the receiver end. After waiting for the limited amount of time, the timeout event is occurred, and the sender has come to know that we didn't receive the acknowledgement 2 from the receiver end. So that might be possible that the data frame 2 is lost during the transmission, or something happened there, right? So after waiting for the predefined waiting time, the timeout event is occurred and sender is retransmitting that data frame whose acknowledgement is not received. So after waiting for whose acknowledgement is not received, so after that, the sender is retransmitting the data frame 2 at the receiver end, right? Likewise, we are handling the situation where the acknowledgement is lost. So that's all about the selective repeat protocol. In that, we have seen that how the error yes bit is handled. What if the frame is lost or the acknowledgement is lost, right? So that's all about the selective repeat protocol. After that, let's discuss the high level data link control protocol, right? So high level data link control, right? HDLC. It is a bit oriented protocol for communication over point to point and multiple ring. The configuration and the transfer modes. The HDLC provide the two transfer modes that can be used in a different configuration. Normal response mode NRM and asynchronous balanced mode ABM. Right? After that, let's see. It is a bit oriented protocol. After that, let's discuss about the frame type. So which kind of frames are having in the HDLC? There are the mainly three type of the frames: information frame, supervisory frame, and unnumbered frame. The information iframe is stand for the information frame. The iframe is used to transport the user data and the control information that is relating to the user data, right? So information frame is containing the data and the control information that is related to the user data. After that, another kind of the frame is there, that is supervisory frame, or we can say that S frame. That S frame is used to transport the control information, and the last type is the unnumbered frame, U frame, right? So it is reserved for the system management. So let's discuss the how it is structured. Right, the frame format of the iframe, S frame, and U frame we are discussing. In that, main at max 6 part is there in the iframe. The structure of the iframe is, first of all, it is having the flag, after that address, after that control, after that user information, FCS, and flag. Right, S frame is having the flag, address, control, FCS, and flag, and U frame is having the flag, address, control, management information, and the FCS and the flag, right? So at max it is having the 6 part. So let's discuss what its part is stand for, right? So what is the functionality of the flag, address, control information, FCS, and all that, let's discuss in term, right? So in that, what do you mean by the flag, right? The flag field, in that the flag field is a 8-bit sequence that identifies the both the beginning and the end of the frame, right? At the beginning and the end of the frame, there must be flag field, right? It is 8-bit sequence, right? After that, the another type is address, right? So it contains the address of the secondary station. If a primary station create a frame, it contains two address, and if secondary station is create the frame, it contains the from address, right? So that's how the address field is having, right? After that, the control is used for the flow and the error control information. It contains the user data at the iframe and the management information and the uframe, right? FCS. What do you mean by the FCS? The frame check sequence is stand for the FCS, right? So it is used in the HDLC error detection technique. It contains the CRC. FCS is the frame check sequence. It is the HDLC high level data link control error detection technique. It contains the CRC, right? In this session, we have seen the HDFC and the selective repeat protocol, right? So that's all about today's session. Thank you for the watching.